New autokill set. What? So it turns out the editor's autokill settings got changed in the new update. And you know, I figured my channel needs content anyway. It's time to make a video about this. Okay, so first things first. Now, when you click the object button, it gives you options on what type of object you want. So if I click normal, that just means it'll behave like any normal object that hurts you when you touch it. There's this new thing called decoration, which means the object will be there, but it won't be able to hurt you. Obviously, you can use it to decorate your levels. Helpers, as you know, are the transparent warnings that you put before attacks, and empty makes the object invisible and unable to harm you. And there's also this option that lets you choose what shape you want it to be. And finally, there's persistent, which I'm going to explain later in the video. For now, I'll just make a normal object and continue from there. So if you look up here next to name, this little area where the checkboxes used to be, it's been replaced with this drop-down menu where you can change your type of object, normal, helper, decoration, or empty. So this next feature is time of death. Okay. This is a new method of controlling autokill, basically. So here you have a bunch of different settings you can use to control when your object disappears. I'm not gonna say die, I'm just saying disappears, alright? So fixed time means you input a number into this little box and the object just disappears after that many seconds. So right now, the object will disappear after 4 seconds. If I alter it, the length of the object changes on the timeline. So for this next feature, if I add a keyframe to the rotation timeline, and then in the drop-down menu, select Last KF, the object's autokill will behave like regular autokill. It will automatically disappear after the last keyframe. And the next feature, if I select Last KF Offset, it's actually a combination of the last two settings. After the final keyframe, the object will disappear after a given number of seconds that you type in here. So right now, the final keyframe is here, but the object will still wait 2 additional seconds before disappearing. So finally, there's song time. This kills an object once a specific time in the song is reached. So right now, I'm at like 53 seconds? So if I select song time and I put in a time like 56 seconds, as you can see, it stops exactly that many seconds into the song. So now that I've explained all this, if you click object and you click persistent, it automatically creates an object that lasts until the very end of the song. It may not look like it right now, but that's because the object is collapsed. That's a new feature. You can now collapse your objects by clicking this little button with the 3 dots. And as you can see, the object lasts until the very end of the song. So some other things that the update changed. The editor later slider is gone, and it's been replaced with these buttons that let you switch the object between the different layers. Also, the clicking the BG button doesn't automatically create a background pulsar anymore. It lets you open the menu or create a new one. So that should be it for all the new features. I'll be honest, I really don't know what to put as the outro for these videos, other than silly goof-ups I made while I was recording. Has been replaced with these buttons that let you switch between the layers, and The editor layer slider is gone. It's been replaced with these 3 buttons. These 5 buttons. What the hell's wrong with me?